Hi, everybody. It's time for DB's Delight, the quiz show where DB Doorbell knows all the answers. Guy Phillips asks all the questions, and students from St. Louis area schools compete for fun and fantastic prizes. It's all here on DB's Delight.
Our hosts for today's show are DB Doorbell and Guy Phillips.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, Chris.
Thank you so much.
Oh, yeah.
Well, DB, hello to you.
How you doing, Guy? We're the host this week.
Yeah, we are?
Yeah, as always, of course.
Why spoil a good thing?
Oh, yeah, but it's going to be a great show.
Who's with us today?
Well, our special guests today are from St. Clement's School of St. Louis. Wow! What a stunning ensemble.
Is that St. Clement like St. Mark Twain?
You know, they used to be St. Clement of Rome, but now they're St. Clement.
Ooh, how about
I think next year they'll be St. Clem.
Well,
it's a shorter cheer.
Yes, it's wonderful.
Yeah.
We'll get over there and talk to those students momentarily.
Yeah.
We have a great crowd and some great contestants.
Great contestants.
And it's your job to introduce our first one.
Absolutely. Our first contestant for round one is Gretchen Meyer. Yeah.
Welcome to DB's Delight, Gretchen.
Hi, Gretchen.
It's lovely to have you on the show, and can you tell us something about yourself?
I like basketball and gymnastics, and my favorite food are enchiladas.
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 Yeah. Guy has been known to be the big enchilada.
I love smoked enchiladas.
Yeah.
Have you ever had those?
No, I eat great enchiladas. What are you talking about? I've never heard of those.
All right, Gretchen, Welcome to the show, and good luck to you. And who is Gretchen's opponent?
Gretchen's opponent is Salim Hawatma. Hi, Celine.
Hi, Celine. Can you tell us something about yourself?
Yes. I enjoy playing soccer, baseball, and tennis, and my favorite subjects are science and geography.
Yeah, but do you like enchiladas?
No.
Oh, well, then you could never go out with Gretchen.
No, we're only going to serve them on this side. Yeah.
Okay. Welcome to the show, Salim. You ready to play?
Yes.
Okay, Gretchen, how about you?
Yeah.
DB?
Guy, let's hear those enchilada rules.
All right, the enchilada rules. The object of DB's Delight is to get as many points as you possibly can. I'll ask the question. DB starts the bell board.
Yeah.
If you think you know the answer to the question, then hit your button. Gretchen, press your button there. That stops our bell board, determines the point value of the question. In this case, it will be worth 2 points.
Oh, yeah.
If you got it right, Gretchen, you'd get those 2 points. But if you missed it, I'd go over to Salim and ask him if he knew the answer. And if he got it right, Salim would get those 2 points. Keep your eye on the center of our bell board. That's our bonus star. And that can really boost your score.
Yeah.
The first time you hit it, it's worth 10. The second time, it's 11 and 1 point each time thereafter. Now, the winner of round one will face the winner of round two in our third round. That's our winner's round. And have a chance of coming back at the end of the year for DB's Grand Delight.
Oh, yeah. We can't wait for that, can we?
No, sir.
Yeah.
Gretchen, you all set?
Mm-hmm.
Salim.
Yeah.
DB.
Let's do it, Guy.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Good luck, Gretchen. Good luck, Salim. Yeah.
All right. Best of luck to both of you. Hermetically sealed in a CBS rubber band. Our questions for round one.
Yeah.
How many things would I find in 3 dozen? How many things would I find in 3 dozen?
Whoa!
For a bonus star, a way to start off, Salim.
36.
36,
wow! Red hot start. Yeah.
12 to a dozen times 3. Who was the president of the United States when the bomb was dropped on Hiroshima? Salim?
Harry S. Truman.
That's right. And Salim is ahead 14 to nothing. Gretchen, you can get right back into the game with this question. It's a math question. You should compute it in the order it's given. That's very important. 50 times 3 minus 10. What does that equal? Yes, Gretchen, for
140.
Five. 140, right.
Wow. They are smart at St. Clement's.
Right, you are, DB. Yeah. They're off to a fast start. Gretchen, you're trailing by 9 points. The suffix est means which of the following? The least, the most, or more than? Yes, Salim.
The most.
That's right.
Oh, yeah. Est. As in the mostest.
And in DB's case, that's best.
B-E-S-T,
okay. Yeah. The instrument used to measure earthquakes is called a... Yes, Elise?
Seismograph.
A seismograph is right.
Wow.
Wait, I just burned my fingers
going
so fast.
Yeah, I don't think you're going to get paid today.
I'll have to slow down.
Yeah.
All right, I have sympathy for you.
Thank you. Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, I haven't finished yet. Spell the...
Sorry, hold it together.
That's all right. Yeah. Spell the word sympathy. Yes, Salim.
S-Y-M-P-H-A-M-Y.
No, that's wrong.
No.
Gretchen, sympathy.
Sympathy. S-Y-M-P-H-A-T. S-Y-M-P-A-T-H-Y?
No, that's wrong.
I have sympathy for all of you.
That's
right. It's S-Y-M-P-A-T-H-Y.
There you go, DB.
Yeah.
All right, we'll throw that one out. Remember your capitals, too. Capital S.
Yeah, right? you have a lot of sympathy.
Sure, when we have those spelling questions. The Atlantic Ocean is which direction from St. Louis? Which direction is the Atlantic Ocean, Gretchen?
East.
East for five.
Yeah,
right.
You're going the short way. Oh, yeah.
30-10 is the score. Dallas, Falcon Crest, the Cosby Show, Dynasty, and the A-Team all have what in common? What do they have in common? Falcon Crest, the Cosby Show, Dynasty, the A-Team. What do they have in common? For 6 points, Salim.
They're all on Channel 5.
No, that's wrong. That's wrong.
I think we're going to have to bleep this out.
Where is that ejector seat?
Yeah.
No, that was not only a wrong guess, but it was really incorrect. Gretchen, can you take a guess?
They're on at 7 o'clock?
No.
Well, I know, guys.
All right, DB.
I star in none of them. Oh, I'm sorry. What's the answer?
That's right. They're the most popular TV shows this season.
Oh, terrific.
Pretty simple.
What about DB's Delight?
Round one music here for you. Listen to this. The popular hit by Rick Springsteen is the number 4 on the top 10 rundown.
Is that Bruce Springsteen?
Bruce, what did I say, Rick?
Yeah, you're thinking of somebody else.
No, I meant, well, whatever.
Who cares?
What's the name of this tune?
Listen. The times are tough, man. Just getting tougher. This whole world is rough.
Gretchen.
Cover Me.
Oh, yeah.
Cover Me is right.
All right.
And who sings it, Gretchen?
Bruce
Springsteen, okay.
Yeah, I think Rick Springfield wishes he did.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, they gave me Rick Springsteen.
Oh, yeah.
What am I
doing?
All right, the major St. Louis airport is what? Yes, Salim.
Lambert Airport.
Lambert or Lambert International is right for 7 points.
I'll take it.
37-14, Salim has the lead. If your teeth need braces, you should go to which of the following? Salim.
Orthodontist.
Oh, yeah.
Orthodontist for four, right.
He'll pick you up.
How many days would I find in 8 weeks? A little bit of math there. Nobody rang in, DB.
Nope. Well, that's the end of...
No, that's
no,
the end.
No, we won't take it. That's the end of round one, guys.
End of round one, yeah. And our winner is Salim with 41 points.
Oh, yeah. Way to go, Salim.
Congratulations, Salim. You'll be coming back for our winner's round. That's round three. And Gretchen, you played a great game. You had 14 points. And we have a little something for you. Listen.
Oh, yeah.
And for being such a great contestant on DB's Delight, you will receive this DB's Delight t-shirt, given only to the special contestants on our show. Wear your new t-shirt everywhere and let friends know that you were our contestant on DB's Delight.
Oh, yeah. There's 56 days in 8 weeks, but we're only going to be gone for 120 seconds after these messages. Yeah.
Stay tuned for round two next on DB's Delight. Welcome back to round two of DB's Delight.
Oh, yeah, super. Welcome back to Dance Fever. I'm Denny Terrio, and this is Motion. Boy, that got a laugh.
Okay, nobody liked that one.
Let me try again. Thank you. Welcome back to DB's Delight. Our special guest today, Guyer, from St. Clement School of St. Louis. Nice dress code.
Oh, they are good-looking students.
Oh, yeah.
We'll talk to them shortly.
Yeah.
It's time, DB, for that real kid letter.
Well, let's hear the letter from the real kid.
There must be one out there anyway.
Yeah. Somebody's watching.
Dear Guy and DB, I love your show so much. I love the Divine Ding Dong. It's about the only one we've ever heard of.
Yeah, that's one I can have framed.
I can watch whenever I can.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. We'll work on that sentence.
Yes. Yeah. I am 8 years old, and I go to Forsyth School.
Ah.
I spell nearly every word in my spelling questions.
All right.
I'm one of the two best spellers in my class.
Yeah.
My favorite subjects, of course, are spelling, math, French, reading, and science.
I can spell math.
Thanks a lot. Yours
truly. M-A-T-H. I'm sorry, I got confused.
Allison Carfeld
Thank
of
you,
St.
Allison.
Louis.
That's a wonderful letter.
And DB, we have some things for Allison, don't we?
We have a treasure trove of gifts. We have a special autograph card with Guy's face on it, unfortunately. But I'm on there, too. And a custom-designed DB's Delight pennant and pencil.
All right, enough of this nonsense.
Oh, yeah.
Moving into our second round, let's meet our contestant number one for round two.
Contestant number one for round two is Chris Selberg. Hi, Chris.
Welcome to the show, Chris. Thanks for joining us. You know the rules. Now we need to find out something about you.
Hi, I like sports. My favorite food is pizza, and my favorite subject is math.
Well, hot spiced food these kids here love.
Italian and Mexican so far.
Yeah, right. Well, good luck to you, Chris. I like the twist beads on there. They might bring you some good luck.
Yeah.
Okay. DB, who is her opponent?
I'd like to get some of those. Oh, her opponent is Dennis Brady. Yeah!
There he is.
Hey, Dennis.
One of the original Brady Bunch.
Oh, yeah.
Dennis Brady. Dennis, we want to hear something about yourself.
I like farming, soccer, and basketball. And my favorite subjects are math and science.
It's not easy to grow basketballs these days, you know?
No.
Weather hasn't been good.
Did you say farming?
Yeah.
Wow, I don't think we've ever had anyone interested in farming. Do you live on a farm?
Well, half the year.
Oh, that's exciting.
Good for you. Well, welcome to the show, Dennis. And best of luck. You ready to play in round two?
Yeah.
Okay, don't be nervous now, okay? Have some fun. Chris, you all set to go?
Yeah.
Okay, DB?
I want to go out to the farm.
Later,
it sounds like more fun, but let's play the round.
Be the funny farm.
Oh, yeah. Good luck, Chris. Good luck, Dennis.
All right. Get your hands on your buttons. Get ready to play round two. Here is our first question. In which of the following states would I find the capital city of Albany? Pennsylvania, New Jersey, or New York? Pennsylvania, New Jersey, or New York for 3 points, Chris.
New York.
New York
is
right.
Yeah.
What do we call the answer to a division problem? Is it the quota, the sum, or the quotient? Yes, Chris.
Quotient.
Quotient for 8 is right.
Right on.
And Chris jumps out to an early 11-0 lead. Dennis, a bonus star will bring you right back into the game here. Compute the following equation in the order that it's given. 4 times 3 times 8. 4 times 3 times 8. I hear the calculators whirring, and there is a button for 6 points. Dennis.
68.
No, that's wrong. Can you tell me, Chris?
94.
Both wrong.
Close. It's 96, guy.
96. All right. Back to math class for both of you. Who became president when John F. Kennedy was assassinated? Was it Nixon, Ford, or Johnson, Chris?
Johnson.
Johnson is right for 8 points.
What an upbeat question.
Yeah, we have one of those a day.
Yeah, I love those assassination questions. They put a crimp in my morning.
Keep us toned down a little bit. 19-0 is the score. Chris has the lead. In the English language, when we say that a word is an antonym of another word, what do we mean? What does that mean, Dennis?
Opposite.
That is the opposite of another word, right.
Yeah.
Good for you. And Dennis is on the scoreboard with 2 points. A person that studies stars, planets, and the like is called what, Dennis?
Astronomer.
Astronomer, right. And Dennis quickly catches up. He's only trailing by 8 points. This is a complete sentence. Spell the word complete. Or sentence, I'm sorry, sentence. Spell the word sentence, Chris.
S-E-N-T-E-N-C-E.
Right. That was not a complete thought on my part. Remember your capitals, okay? Capital S. Which sport would you associate the following? The blast, the comets, the sting, earthquakes, and steamers, Dennis?
Soccer.
Indoor soccer, for 9 points. 26-20, Chris still has the lead. In Mexico, they wear sombreros. What do we wear in the United States? What do we call that?
Hat.
A hat, right, sure. 34-20 now. Here is our round two music question. Get your ears ready. Rod Stewart has been making hits for the past 10 years and has another hit currently climbing the charts. Listen to this and tell me what the title of his latest hit is.
Yeah.
Some guys.
Chris there.
Some guys have all the luck.
Some guys have all the luck, 39-20 now. Which was the 49th state to enter the Union? Dennis.
Alaska.
Alaska.
Oh, yeah.
What part of the body do hallucinogens... DB, you want to hit the board there? What part of the body do hallucinogens affect? Is it the heart, the mind, or the lungs? Yes, Chris.
The mind.
Yeah, we're going to take it.
All right, DB, we'll take it
because
for 2 points.
Because there's no such thing as the hook.
Okay. 41-26. Chris got that one. Herman Melville wrote the book Moby Dick. What was Moby Dick? Yes, for 9.
A whale?
It was a whale.
Big one,
right. And that makes the score 50-26. Which of the following groups of people came to America to have freedom of worship? Was it the Catholics, the Lutherans, or the Pilgrims? Dennis?
Pilgrims.
Pilgrims,
right
you are. And that's an additional 5 points stacked onto your score. You're down by 19. What is the nickname of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania's professional baseball team? DB, hit the bellboard. Is it, for 5 points, Chris.
Steelers?
Go ahead.
Steelers?
No, that's wrong. Dennis, can you tell me? The professional baseball team in Pittsburgh, what's the name? It's worth 5 points if you know.
No time, guy. It's the Pirates, and
that's
the end of round two.
And our winner is Chris with 50 points.
Way to go, Chris. Congratulations.
Don't go anywhere, Chris. Stay right where you are. You're going to be playing in round three, okay? And Dennis, you played a great game. You really did. And we have some nice things selected for you. Take a listen.
Oh, yeah.
And for being such a great contestant on DB's Delight, you will receive this DB's Delight t-shirt, given only to the special contestants on our show. Wear your new t-shirt everywhere and let friends know that you were our contestant on DB's Delight.
And just for Allison writing in, the Divine Ding Dong is next with more stuff after this break.
Don't miss the Divine Ding Dong and the Winner's Round next on DB's Delight. And now, the Winner's Round on DB's Delight.
Welcome back to DB's Delight on the Winner's Round. I'm Guy Phillips, sitting in between Brian and Andy here with St. Clement. Yay! Or, if you will, for the moment, St. Comedy. And now it's time for the portion of our show we call the Divine Ding Dong.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. Obviously, they watch the show. Thank you.
All right.
Oh, please sit down.
All right, we need to trick this guy this week.
Yeah.
Who has a joke riddle? Oh, these guys are primed. They're ready to go. How about this young lady who looks like she's serving something to me on a cracker? Stand up here and give me your name.
Kim Ballardo.
Okay, Kim Ballardo. What is your joke or riddle for DB?
What do you call a pickup truck hauling a dozen and a half pigs?
Did you get that one?
Nah, but it doesn't matter. I'm just going to ad-lib a spoof answer.
All right.
Yeah.
What is it?
Give me some music. Oh. All right, get rid of the music. How about an 18 squealer?
Right.
All right.
All right, Kim.
I made that up.
That's pretty good. There's your...
I'm red hot.
Who else has one here for me? Oh, right here. How about this gal in green? Stand up and give us your name.
Maria Tumbarella.
Is this your own joke, or did somebody just hand that to you?
No.
She has writers.
All right, your own joke.
How does the water get into the watermelon?
How does the water... And this is something I know you're wondering at home.
It's a science question,
of course.
We've
never really had this on the show. And there's a good reason. It's boring. I don't know. I imagine there's some kind of pipe connected to it. Thanks, guy. I got a giggle, yeah.
What an ad lib.
Thank you.
What is it?
Planted in the spring.
Planted in the spring.
Sit down.
All right.
That's terrible.
Boo. Yeah. All right. Wait a minute. All right, this guy right here. Stand up here. Come on, get up here.
Sounds like somebody let a dog in here.
Got an alligator on his shirt there. What's your name, sir?
Oh, Tim.
All right, Tim, what's your joke?
Who was the famous chicken who ruled the West and later became president of the United States?
Tim.
Who was the famous chicken that rode the West and later became the President of the United States?
We may have to give equal time here.
Gotta know this in this election year?
Yeah.
What are you doing with that crystal ball?
I'm just fondling it. It's kinda nice on my fingertips. Try it. No. I don't know.
Teddy Roosevelt.
Teddy Roosevelt. Okay, there you go.
Not bad.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to play that exciting round, the conclusion of DB's Delight, round three, the winner's round.
Oh, yeah. And coming back from round one is Salim Hawatma. Nice ovation for Salim.
Ovation.
Yeah, and from round two, Chris Selberg.
Hey! I think that last round, Divine...
Everyone is so tense about the winner's round, they just can't applaud.
Took everything out of them.
Yeah.
All right. Get ready. Good luck, Salim. Good luck, Chris. Here is your first question for our winner's round. How many years are between each Olympiad? 2, 4, or 6, Chris?
4.
4 is right for 3 points. And an early lead for Chris here. The thinnest blood vessel in the human body is what? Yes, Salim.
Capillaries.
Capillaries, yeah. Right for five.
In my head.
Here is our math question. You can follow along at home. See if you can figure this out. Compute it in the order it's given. That's important. 50 times 4 plus 50. What does that equal? 50 times 4 plus 50 for 7 points, Salim.
250.
Oh, yeah. Right, you are.
In what body of water would I find the Bermuda Triangle? Yes, Chris.
The Atlantic Ocean.
Atlantic is right for three. 12-6 in the winner's round. What is the main nerve of the eye? Is it the cornea, the pupil, or the optic? Yes, Salim for five.
The optic.
Optic is right for 5 points. And that brings you to 17-6. You're in the lead.
Yeah.
Many persons require blood transfusions. Spell the word transfusion.
Wow.
Yes, for a bonus star, Chris.
T-R-A-N-S-F-U-S-I-O-N.
Oh, yeah.
That's correct.
Tough word.
Remember your capitals.
Yeah.
Bush is to Reagan as who is to Mondale? Yes, Chris.
Ferraro.
Ferraro, yeah. For nine, right. And that puts you in the lead for the first time this round, Chris, 25-17. Name the planet closest to the sun. The planet closest to the sun is worth 7 points, Salim.
The moon?
No, that's wrong. Can you take a guess, Chris?
Mercury?
Mercury, yeah. Is right. There you go.
Boy, it's a little warm there. Yeah.
Who led the South's forces in the Civil War? D.B., you want to start the billboard?
Not particularly.
Was it Lincoln, Lee, or Grant? Yes, Salim.
Grant?
No, that's wrong. Was it Lincoln or Lee? And we need the audience to be quiet back here. Chris, take your guess.
Lee?
Lee is right.
Oh, yeah.
And that's worth five.
Yeah.
Couple of bonus stars, Salim. You'll be right back in the game here. Here's our music question. The group has been a favorite of teenagers for many years. They've done a TV series, and now they've got a cartoon series. And it is named after this group. Tell us who this is. For a bonus star, Salim.
Menudo?
No, that's wrong. Chris?
The Jacksons.
Jacksons, oh, yeah. That's right.
Yeah. They needed us to plug the record, didn't they?
You bet. Yeah. They need the extra cash.
Yeah.
You rung in there quick, Salim, but you missed. Who is the father of vaccination, Pasteur, Bell, or Jenner? The father of vaccination, Pasteur, Bell, or Jenner? Yes, Salim.
Jenner.
Jenner is right for seven.
And he did so well in the Olympics.
In what year did World War II begin? What was the year? D.B. hit the billboard. What year did World War II, 1939, 1945, or 1937? Yes, Salim.
1939.
39 is right.
Oh, yeah.
What famous building is located at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue in Washington, D.C.? Famous building. Yes, Chris?
The White House?
That's right, yeah.
I thought it was the Vaseline headquarters.
Yeah. What is the capital of Argentina? Buenos Aires, La Paz, or...
Whoa.
Yes, for a bonus star.
Buenos Aires.
Buenos Aires, Buenos Aires, that's right. When you carefully look for mistakes in a paper that you have written, you are what? Revising? Yes, Chris.
Proofreading.
Proofreading, right. What country first declared war against the Germans, which was the start of World War II? Was it Poland, the United States, or France? Yeah, for 2 points, Salim.
France.
No, that's wrong. Is it Poland or the United States?
Poland.
Right.
Yeah.
Poland.
All right. Well, guys, that's the end of the winner's round.
The end of the winner's round.
Yeah.
And our winner is Chris with 76 points.
Wow, way to go, Chris. Way to go.
Chris, congratulations. You're our winner.
You.
And with 76 points, that's the highest this year. Here's what we've got for you.
For winning today on DB's Delight, we hope you'll enjoy this AM/FM pop-out stereo receiver. Use it at home or pop out the AM/FM receiver and carry it with you everywhere you go. Congratulations for your big win today on DB's Delight.
And Salim, you did well. You're going to go home and practice that wrist action to get that button down in there. You had 26 points, and that's a good score for us on DB's Delight. We have some nice things for you to take home as well.
And for being such a great winner's round contestant on DB's Delight, you can now listen to your favorite music anytime, anywhere, when you slip on the headphones of this popular AM/FM stereo receiver. Congratulations on making it to the winner's round on DB's Delight.
I want to thank our special guest, St. Clement. They were a great group. I'm Guy Phillips. It's been fun, but we're done. We'll see you next time on DB's Delight.
So long. Yeah. And for you guys in the home audience, can you really afford not to send a letter or question to our show? Just mail it to Guy and me at DB's Delight, KMOX TV, number 1 Memorial Drive, St. Louis, Missouri, 63102. Everyone who writes in will get a DB's Delight autograph card, but if we use your letter or question on our show, we'll also send you a DB's Delight pennant and pencil. I had a great time. Have a great day. Bye-bye.